All right, I want you to keep your head nice and still and look all the way down to your toes or to your hand. And up, 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 look up. Use your eyes to look up. There you go. So what I'm looking at is the movement of that lid from down to up.
Yeah.
I had a mentor who I actually had known growing up and had become a retina surgeon in New York, so I went to watch her. She did cataract surgery, and it was on this woman who owned a bunch of Picasso paintings, and she couldn't see her paintings anymore. Day one after surgery, she could see 20/20. Her whole life was changed by this tiny, super elegant procedure. That's how I chose ophthalmology. I'm Alexandra Elliott. I'm the director of Oculoplastics at Boston Children's Hospital.
You should be pretty comfortable. Tylenol afterwards. I'll give you an antibiotic cream that you just put on that incision. I think it's gonna take about 2 hours. Do you have questions?
No.
Oculoplastics is focusing mostly on reconstructive work around the eye. A lot of the babies have problems with their eyelids where they aren't formed correctly, and so we try to make more symmetric eyelids for them. Everyone gets a pretty thorough exam right up front, and I try to get all the information really quick, within the first few minutes. Then the anxiety kind of leaves the room, because I've gotten the data that we need to give a real diagnosis, and the parents don't have to feel like they have to wrestle the baby. And so a lot of the exam is just sort of educating the parents as to what is going on, what to be worried about, what not to be worried about. So in his case, for whatever reason, this muscle just didn't develop.
Yeah.
Okay? Mm-hmm. I bring this all the way forward to here. So we're tightening it.
Okay? Right. How many of these have you performed?
Oh, hundreds.
Hundreds and hundreds? Yeah. Okay, good. Glad to hear that. Yeah. I'm just more concerned about like adverse like side effects or like something that could happen.
What I do is a little more visible to the world. I've definitely had some children who are very introverted because they had a droopy eyelid and they felt very self-conscious. They'd hang their hair over their face. Parents are always worried about how other people will treat their child. And if you can get rid of any anomalies, their lives have changed because they feel better about who they are, how they look. They also can see better. One thing about being a physician is that it's a skill that you can take care of any human being. You don't have to speak the same language, you don't have to have the same culture. You can just take care of other people.